Hello, everybody. Good morning, or good afternoon, or good evening, depending on when you're watching this. Today, we're going to do our extremely popular black and white owl. So before I get started, I'll just say I'm using a 12 by 16 canvas. I've given it two coats of black paint, let it dry in between coats, or use a hair dryer. So two coats of black paint already. And what I'll do when I put the video up, I'll also put a photo of this little outline that I've done, so you can work on that before you jump right into your painting. What I did, I used white paint and just did my simple kind of out around the head, down the body, the eye, and the beak. Okay, so part of his face is off the canvas, so this is just kind of half, or a little more than half, because we can see almost the full beak. I did it with paint just so you could see, and I didn't have any chalk handy, but if you buy the white chalk, like kids chalk, you can buy it at the dollar store, or I bought some at Staples actually. If you use chalk, you can wipe it away, you can paint right over it. So use a little light chalk outline, or if you prefer, you can do the paint, or you can use a pencil, totally up to you. So painted black, did my outline. Now for this painting, like, I'm going to stress to you guys, like, you don't need to go out and buy really, really expensive things to create this painting. I'm using just simple white and black paint. You can use craft paint if that's all you have. If you have professional acrylic paint, go ahead and use it. These paints are a little thinner, what I'm using today, and they're my kind of student grade acrylic paint that I buy for my classes. So the one I'll just show you, it's a little messy, but it's a 2-liter bottle and it's called Start Academic Acrylic Paint in Titanium White. I buy this online at Curry's Art Store online. So that's where I get that paint. And then I have the same one in carbon black. It's a little paint on over the word there, but you can get the idea. So these are the two that I'm using today, but again, white and black, as long as you have a white and a black, whatever one you have, you can use. And this painting, you really only need about two brushes. So I'm gonna use this 1/2 inch flat brush, just a simple 1/2 inch brush. And let's see. And I'm gonna use another this brush with the blue handle and the gold, that's from the dollar store. It's literally a dollar for a pack of three. So that's a 1/4 inch flat brush. So that's pretty much all I'm gonna use for this painting. If you have like a small pointy brush, you may want that right on the end, but I think for what I'm gonna do today, I'll only need these two brushes. So you don't need a lot of brushes either. We're gonna do our owl in three steps. So first step, I'm going to pull some black and white together. And I just wanna create a dark charcoal gray, really deep gray, almost like just a shade lighter than our black. We'll go lighter at each step. So the first step, it may be a little hard to kind of see it on your canvas, but it's necessary for the beginning step of our owl. So this is a pretty dark charcoal gray. I'm just mixing it with that 1/2 inch brush. So that's gonna be kind of my first color. So first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna come just kind of at an angle out from the eye, and I'm gonna start just brushing kind of his horned feathered part that comes down across the forehead on an angle, right down almost to that eye, and then about there, and it goes off the edge on that side. So that's our first piece. Redip your brush. We're going to use the same charcoal gray for everything first. Then I'm going to lay my brush kind of flat on my canvas, and I'm going to kind of create this sort of speckly forehead. My brush strokes are condensed closer together near the top, and as I come down the forehead, there, I'm just bring this down a little further. They're a little further apart. So you can see my paint is closer together up here, but we're still leaving this black to be shown there. We don't want to cover everything in. Next, we're going to come down this line just with kind of a choppy little fuzzy broken line. So you see we're covering all of our initial little sketch, and we're keeping the roundness, and we're going to come up to about there. You don't want to come down this curve and then come straight across. Keep that round kind of shape there. We'll just bring it up to about there, and we'll do a little touch on this side as well, because we see this little kind of corner here. The next thing we're going to do around the eye is, actually first we'll do the eye itself. So re-dip your brush in your charcoal, and I'm going to lay it flat, and I'm going to make this kind of half circle. Don't worry about this little bit of white there. We'll cover that later. Not a problem. And that's the first step of our eye. Don't worry if you got a little wiggly edge around your eye, because on the end, we're gonna come around the outside of that with a black line and kind of clean everything up. That'll be later near the end of our painting. So I'm gonna re-dip my brush again. And now we're gonna create kind of this starburst feather pattern around the eye. So we're gonna start on the outside edge and pull our brush strokes in towards the eye. But all of our brush strokes should be pointing towards the center of the eye. Okay, so starting out here, pressing and kind of flicking in towards the center of the eye. If you keep them pointing toward the center of the eye, you're going to get the right kind of effect. If you point them in a different direction or not quite on the right angle, you may notice that it doesn't look quite like you want it. So notice how all of those brush strokes are pointing in towards the center of that eye. And we're going to give a little hint of one over there too, because we can see that little corner. Next thing we're going to do, re-dip your brush, same color paint again. We're going to come just outside this kind of fuzzy line with another one. Little broken kind of fuzzy. Come right in there, leaving a little bit of black in between that, guys. And then we bring it down, brushing out down the side of his belly. We're gonna fill in our beak with that dark gray. One full coat of your gray on the beak. And it goes off the edge of our canvas there. that. Then we're gonna re-dip our brush again and we're gonna fill his belly in. As we do that, I kind of like to keep the brush strokes sort of with a little curve to it because that gives us that illusion of his fluffy round belly. And you'll notice, again, not filling everything in, guys. Leave some of the black there. You want to be able to see that a little bit of black coming through. So don't fill everything in so that it's one big solid coat of gray paint. And I'm kind of hitting the canvas, not straight on like this, kind of hitting it with the corner of the brush. And that's your first coat. I'm gonna bring this a little bit in here, just to bring it in, there we go. So I'm gonna just give a little quick rinse of my brush just to get all that dark out of it and a pat dry on my paper towel. And now we wanna create a little bit lighter of our gray. So we'll just use some of the gray we already have. If I tried to lighten that whole thing, it would take me so much white paint. So don't try to lighten all your dark if you have a bunch left. Just take a little bit of dark to the side, add some white, and you'll start to get that lighter gray. And you know, what I usually do, because we don't know if this will work and be the perfect color, but I'll do a few brush strokes and just see. And if it's too light or too dark, then I'll come back and kind of adjust it and mix a little more. But I think this may be okay. And we're just gonna go back over everything again, but we're not gonna fill it all in. You're gonna leave some of that dark showing through. So there's our little horned area. Then our speckly top, same as we did earlier, but we're just gonna do a little less. So you're gonna bring it down, but you're not gonna fill in everything. So you can still see some of that really dark gray still poking through. That's what we want. Like that. And for the eye, we're not gonna go the whole circle. We're just gonna do part of it. Just like that. And we'll leave part of that dark gray showing. Same with our starburst feather pattern. We'll start on the outside and we'll flick it in, but not covering everything. Pointing all of our brush strokes towards the center of the eye. And don't forget our couple little pieces there. Then we do our first little fuzzy line. Like that. Now for the nose, I'm gonna dab a little bit down the center of the nose. And I'm gonna just tap it out with my finger and just help blend it out a little bit. So there we have a little lightness in the center of his beak. Then we come with our second little fuzzy broken line here. And we just bring that right down the side of the body. Like that. And we're gonna go ahead and give our feathers another go over. So you're gonna notice, see how it's blending a little there? My first coat of gray isn't dry, But it's okay. I like that. I don't want it to kind of just sit on top. I like it to kind of blend in a little bit. So if your first coat of gray is still a little wet, that's good. Let it kind of mix. Let it blend in. You'll notice I'm not using a lot of water with this, guys. So if you are using thick paint from like the tubes, the professional acrylic paint, you're gonna wanna thin out your paint a little bit as you go. Because if you were trying to use like really thick paint with this, you may not get these like little brush strokes that we're going for. So you can see mine is, you know, pretty thin. It's not liquidy running off my plate, but it's definitely a little thinner paint. That's why it's good for students to use and beginners, this type of paint, because you don't have to worry too much about the consistency. It's ready to go. And that's our second layer. So we're gonna give our brush a little rinse. And the last layer, we use just white paint. And then we'll do some little details. Alrighty, so I've rinsed and patted dry, going with my same brush again. So all we've used yet, guys, is our half inch flat brush. For our last layer, we're gonna use just white. And it may look super bright first when you start putting it on, but it kind of blends in, it tones down a little, and it's gonna look good. Our speckly forehead. So see how I'm using just white, but it's blending in a little. It's not too crazy bright. I'm not gonna do the eye yet. I'm gonna use my smaller brush. So I'm just gonna leave the eye. We're gonna do our starburst, same thing over again for the third time, but this time just white. And of course it's blending in a little, but it looks good. I'm not covering everything, so you're still gonna see some of that gray underneath, and we need that because see how we get that depth there. See how that looks almost like 3D. And don't forget your little piece over here. Then we're gonna go over our little line here. And our little piece here. We'll do the same thing on our beak again. I'm gonna add just a little bit of white there, and I'm just gonna tap it out with my finger. Guys, it's painting, it gets messy. It's okay. If you paint a whole picture and you don't get messy, you're not doing it right. That's the fun of it. So there's our next little highlight. Then I'm just gonna go back with my brush on its edge, and I'm just going to touch a little more white, and I'll stop there. That's kind of our little bright highlight on the beak. And then I'll come down my outside edge, my little fuzzy, fluffy edge, and we'll do another coat on our feathers. This time just white, but our gray underneath is still a little wet, so it blends a little, but it looks good. You'll notice as I'm doing this, I'm not going back over. So kind of resist that urge to keep brushing and brushing and brushing in the same spot, because if you do, you're gonna end up blending it all together and you're not gonna get this kind of dramatic effect. So try not to blend too much together. Let what happens if your brush stroke goes on and you kind of get that bit of gray, leave it. But if you overbrush that, you're gonna lose our kind of dramatic effect we're creating here. This is not a, you know, kind of toned down, blended out look. This is a pretty dramatic look we're going for with this white against the black. That's that. So what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna put my half inch brush to the side and I'm gonna go for my quarter inch flat brush. So same shape of brush, just a little narrower. And what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna give him a little shine in his eye. So I'm just taking white paint and going doop, 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 just like that. And we'll do one about right here. Little shine in the eye. Also, a lot of these little owls have this kind of fuzzy, feathery fuzz that comes down onto their beak. So what we'll do for that, white paint on our small flat brush. I'm holding my brush up and down, so I'm making a narrow line. And I'm just going to brush on top of kind of the face and the beak where they meet and give this sort of fuzzy look. And as I come down this way, I'm kind of turning my brush strokes. So he's got that little fuzziness over his beak and it just kind of turns and comes out that way. That's that. Now we're gonna do a little bit of just black next. So still using that smaller brush, flat brush, I've rinsed and patted dry. So the next thing I like to do is take just black paint on that. So you want this a little bit thinner. So if you need to, add a little water to it. And I come straight across here, the eye, and I come around the eye. Just to kind of outline it a little with just black, and that kind of helps it pop out a little. So there's our eye outlined. Then you're gonna take another little bit of black and I'm gonna give him a little dot there and a little dot here, two little nostrils. That's all you need. And the last thing we'll do, same brush, black paint, and we're gonna just give a few little dabs here and there just to create kind of a speckly look to those feathers, little black kind of speckles. Make some a little bigger, some a little smaller. Just tap them in anywhere at all over his fluffy belly. And that's pretty much the last part. We have it all filled in. You have your eye outline, your nostrils, your speckles, and that's about it, guys. There is your black and white dramatic owl. Thanks for watching. We'll see you the next time.